how to play Crow Castle on your PC. Or rather, how to make this turn into this. What if I told you it is both easy and completely free to do so, and you can even use your keyboard to play Crow Castle with. But there's one small thing you have to avoid doing unless you wanna get banned. So join me, I will walk you through it. In order to install Crow Castle from Google Play into your computer, you will need to use an Android emulator, which is a program that creates like a mobile phone inside your PC and allows you to play mobile games inside that program. It sounds a little complicated, but it's actually really simple. It's just like installing any other application in your PC, and there are multiple of different emulators you can use. I have used two different kinds personally myself. Those are the Nox Player and the BlueStacks 5. And currently in here, as you can see on the screen, I'm using BlueStacks 5. And I feel like that works more stable for me. That's why it's my personal choice, at least for now. So the first step is to head into the website of that program and hit the download button. And then simply just install the program like you would do any other program on your PC. And after the installation is done, you should have a similar window like this open up on your PC. And now what we have to do is we have to search for Crow Castle. And once we try to download it, it will actually ask us to sign in with our Google Play account. So right now, use the same account you have been playing Crow Castle on your mobile phone or mobile tablet device with. If you are not playing Crow Castle yet, you can just use any email you want to save your game progress on. But you should just log into your email over here and then you will continue with the installation. So here we are. So now we simply install the game, wait for the installation process to complete. And then we just run the program and load our account into the game. And then we can just start playing Crow Castle on PC. So we just go over here and we load up our game. And tada, our game is loaded up and ready to be played. Now, whenever you want to switch between your mobile device and your PC, you can just save the game on one device, close the game, and then open it up on the other device and load up, and you can switch between devices just like that. You can completely freely change between the two devices as often as you would like. Now, there are two features within the emulator that I want to talk to you about, and I'd recommend you listen really carefully right now. These features are hotkeys and macros or scripts. And now hotkeys for single taps can be used, they are allowed to be used, and you can use those to play Crow Castle with your keyboard. I will show you how it's done in just a moment. But macros and or scripts are not allowed to be used and they will get you banned. So do not risk your account, do not use anything that says macro or anything like that. Just use the game's built-in auto battle feature to play like that, and just stick into using the hotkeys I will show you right now. And what using these hotkeys mean is that you press one button on your keyboard and it will tap one part of the screen once. For example, it will tap the dragon statue once if you press a certain button. And in order to set up your hotkeys, you will use this game controls menu on your right side of the screen. It has this, it looks like a small keyboard, so it should be quite easy to spot. Once you open it up, you will get a window like this, and from this controls editor button over here, you will enable yourself to set up any hotkeys you want to do. And these are the ones I am currently using. This is pretty much done for my dragon hunting setup. I will demonstrate that in a moment. But you can set up any kind of hotkey you want in a way like you just tap on the screen. Like for example, if I would want to use this spot over here, you tap on the screen and then you press whatever key on your keyboard you wanna set up that spot to be used with. For example, T, and then I just click away and now it's set up for T. So if I press T on my keyboard, it will tap this spot on the screen. And if you click and drag this with your mouse, you can move it freely somewhere else if you feel like that's not the spot where you want it to be and you wanna be, for example, on here to use Assassin. And of course you can use this button to delete any of the keys you don't feel like you need. And once you are done, you will just hit the save button in the bottom right side of over here and then just close the controls editor from the X over here. And now once we open this controls editor menu again, you can use this bar over here to set up, like adjust if you want to see the buttons or not on the screen. So I will, usually I have them hidden because I don't like to see them on my screen, but I will put them on full visibility right now so you can see what button is exactly what. So this is what I use, for example, starting a dragon battle. So example, I use the C button on my keyboard to tap the dragon stats you want, like this, so it will open up the dungeon menu. Then I use the X button, tap the bone dragon button, like this, so it will open up the bone dragon window. And then I press C to tap the battle button, which will start the actual battle. Now this account can't beat bone dragon, this is for my main account. But just like that, using three buttons, I can just activate the battle instantly. And also if I press space, I can use the altar as well. So four buttons, and I have started a battle and instantly used my altar. So then I can just keep doing normal dragon hunting stuff. If I would want to, I could set up hotkeys for every hero here as well that I want to use. So if that's something you want to solely play on your keyboard, you can do that as well. But I just kind of want to click stuff as well. So that's why I only have set it up so that I can start the battle with my keyboard and then use my mouse to actually battle the dragon. So again, playing on PC is allowed completely free to do so. Using hotkeys is okay, completely free to do so as well. But using macros is no, it will get you banned, so don't go there. And if you have any questions regarding setting this up or about the hotkeys or anything, leave a comment down below. I will do my best to give you an answer. And I thank you very much for watching. I hope you have a fantastic day and fantastic week ahead of you. Thank you. See you next time, my friends. Laku out.